blood transfusion. The first point is collection and storage of blood. Blood is collected into a citrate, dextrose, anticoagulant. Citrate for anticoagulation and dextrose to keep the viability of red blood cells during storage. Each bag of blood containing 70 to 100 milliliter of citrate dextrose solution and about 400 to 450 milliliter of blood. And the blood is stored at 4 centigrade in a refrigerator. What is the types and indications of blood transfusion? First of all, we take the blood from the donor. When we take the blood from the donor for about 4 to 6 hours, this is called the fresh blood. Fresh blood, if transfused during this period, 4 to 6 hours after donation, this is called the transfusion of fresh whole blood. And it is indicated in coagulation defect because the fresh blood containing coagulation factor and rich in coagulation factor. And given in liver diseases because patient with liver disease has a deficiency in the coagulation factor. And this blood should be given for within 4 to 6 hours after donation. If the blood is not transfused within 4 to 6 hours and is stored in the refrigerator, this is called stored whole blood. And stored whole blood is indicated for class 3 and class 4 hemorrhage. And it can be the life of storage. Storage life of whole blood is 21 days. This blood, if you suspend this blood, the red blood cells settle down. And if you take this red blood cells only and transfuse to the patient, this is called bagged red blood cells. Bagged red blood cells, the storage life is 21 days and indicated for severe anemia in children and in elderly cardiac patients. The red blood cells settle down, and above the red blood cells, which is red in color, there is a yellowish fluid. This yellowish fluid is called plasma. If we take plasma of fresh blood transfusion, this is called fresh frozen plasma and kept in for frozen, and it is indicated in coagulation defect because fresh frozen plasma very, very rich in coagulation factors and also indicated in liver diseases and liver dysfunction because the patient has a deficiency in coagulation factors. We can separate platelets from the blood, and this is called platelet concentrates. And sure, we give platelets to patient with deficiency in platelets. And we all know that deficiency in platelets is a disease called thrombocytopenia. Cryoprecipitate. Cryoprecipitate is very, very rich in fibrinogen and coagulation factor number 8, which is responsible for hemophilia. Deficiency of this factor leading to hemophilia. Therefore, cryoprecipitate is prepared from the fresh frozen plasma and indicated in hemophilia A and in case of hypofibrinogenemia. We can separate factor 8, coagulation factor number 8 from the blood, and deficiency of this factor is responsible for hemophilia A, and sure it is given for patient with hemophilia A. We can separate factor number 9. Number 9 deficiency of this factor is responsible for hemophilia B. Therefore, in hemophilia B, we give factor number 9. We can separate human albumin, 5% and 20% from the blood, and sure albumin concentrates and albumin in 5% or 20% can be given for hypoalbuminemia. And hypoalbuminemia is very, very famous in liver dysfunction, because we all know that the liver is the only source for synthesis of albumin. What is the complication of blood transfusion? We can divide complication of blood transfusion, complication to the donor and the complication to the recipient. First of all, the donor. Pain from the vein break. Pain from vein break may lead to neurogenic shock and collapse during withdrawal of the blood. Or hematoma and thrombophlebitis in this vein. Or anemia. No more than 500 cc are taken from a donor every 6 months. Complication to the recipient. Complication to the recipient. First of all, and the most dangerous complication is transmission of diseases. Transmission of diseases like viral hepatitis, hepatitis B and C, can be transmitted from whole blood or its products. Second dangerous disease is human immune deficiency virus, HIV type 1 and HIV type 2. Which are responsible for acquired immune deficiency syndrome, AIDS. AIDS can be transmitted from whole blood or its product. Also, malaria, syphilis, brucellosis can be transmitted through the blood. Bacterial contamination due to faulty storage or overwarms of the blood more than 1 hour before use. This may present in the patient if the blood is bacterially contaminated. This may lead to septic shock. In addition to transmission of diseases, number two is immunological complications. Immunological complications may be immunological reaction against red blood cells. This leads to acute hemolytic reaction, and this is very, very rare nowadays. Or immune reaction against white blood cells, and this leads to pyrogenic reaction. Or immune response against platelets. This is leading to Berbera. Or immune reaction against plasma protein, leading to allergic reaction. First of all, we will discuss the immune reaction against red blood cells, which lead to acute hemolytic reaction. This is due to presence of antibodies. Antibodies in the recipient against antigen in the donor's blood, or it may be which is due to incompatible blood transfusion, Or this may be due to transfusion of hemolyzed blood due to improper storage for long time or overheat. This nowadays very, very rare. And the symptoms appear after transfusion of 25 to 515. 50 milliliter. Symptoms appear after transfusion of 25 to 50 milliliter. What is the clinical picture of this hemolytic reaction? Initially, there is a sense of heat and pain along the recipient vein. And rapid onset of flushing of the face. Chills, fever, dyspnea, and constricting pain in the chest, and loin pain, tachycardia, and hypotension. In case of hemolytic reaction, there is release of histamine, and histamine leading to flushing of the face, and the position of hemoglobin. The position of hemoglobin of the hemolyzed blood in the pulmonary blood vessels leading to chest symptoms, chest pain and constricting pain in the chest and dyspnea. And the position of hemoglobin in the renal tubule leading to the loin pain. In case of anesthetized patient, the warning signs are abnormal bleeding and continuous hypotension in spite of adequate fluid replacement. After a few hours, mild tinge of jaundice appear with urine becomes dark due to hemoglobinuria. In severe cases, urticaria rashes and anaphylaxis with marked jaundice and anuria due to acute tubular necrosis. What is the management of acute hemolytic reaction? First of all, stop transfusion and donor's blood. Donor's blood and new blood sample from the recipient are sent to the blood banks for repeated typing and matching, cross-matching. Samples from blood and urine send for lab examination. Due to release of histamine from the hemolyzed blood, there are many symptoms, hypotension, flushing of the face, etc. Therefore, we give antihistaminics and hydrocortisone. If there is a shock, anti-shock measures and lactate ringers and the full sphincter should be inserted to observe the urine output and osmotic diuresis by intravenous mannitol and the hemoglobin is precipitated in the renal tubule in acidic urine. Therefore, we should alkaline the urine by Gibbs sodium bicarbonate intravenous. If acute tubular necrosis and acute renal failure occur, proper management of acute renal failure as we take in medicine. The next immunological reaction is biogenic reaction. Biogenic reaction nowadays can be considered as the commonest complication of blood transfusion. It is due to presence of recipient antibody. Antibody in the recipient against donor's white blood cells. The clinical picture is chills, fever, headache, nausea, and vomiting. Sure, we should stop transfusion as any allergic reaction, antihistaminics and corticosteroids, Paracetamol for fever as antibiotic, and stop giving this patient white blood cells. Give the patient only red blood cells. Therefore, the transfusion for this patient with biogenic action is back the red blood cells only. The third transfusion reaction is post-transfusion Berbera. In a patient receiving repeated transfusion, as in hemolytic anemia, the patient may develop antibodies against a donated platelets. Against the donated platelets and destruction of platelets leading to Berbera. Allergic reaction. Allergic reaction, this is occur in patient with repeat transfusion as in hemolytic anemia. Antibodies in the recipient occur against proteins in the donor's plasma. Clinical picture in mild cases, just itching and urticaria. In severe cases, anaphylactic shock, laryngeal edema and collapse may occur due to this severe allergy. As any allergy, antihistaminics and corticosteroids, and sure stop transfusion. Thrombophlebitis of the recipient means due to prolonged transfusion. Air embolism may occur, but this is very rare. Transfusion-related acute lung injury. This is very rare. This is due to incompatibility between donor's antibodies and recipient granulocytes. And this gives the same manifestations of adult respiratory distress syndrome. We stop here and we'll continue in the next video. Thank you for good listening and good luck.